All eyes are on the sun as it's given us some spectacular views over the last couple days. As we switch to our front side sun, you can see the transit of Mercury. Look at it go right there. This is the last time we've got a chance to see this planet transit the sun for more than a decade. So if you didn't catch this view, you're going to have to look at the replay because you won't see it for quite some time. But that's not the only cool thing we've got going on. We also have a coronal hole that's going to be rotating into the Earth's strike zone here in the next 4 days or so. And it could send us some more fast wind and possibly bring some aurora down to high latitude, so stay tuned for that. But that's not all. We also have a new cycle, cycle 25 sunspot right there in the southern hemisphere. This is the second of these new cycle sunspots we've seen in the past week or so. So we're definitely beginning to ramp up on cycle 25. We're not there yet, but we're getting close. As we switch to our far side sun, you can see this is our partially far-sighted monitor. It's kind of looking at the sun from the side. You can see that active region emerge very, very quickly, and it's fizzling and farting and all that. That's really good news to see activity ramp up this quickly, because that means that solar cycle 25 is nearly here. For more details on this week's space weather, including when and where to see aurora and what that new cycle sunspot means for your day, come check out my channel or see me at spaceweatherwoman.com.